making too much noise.
Yeah, I know.
Welcome back to the Blogsy Guys, where we talk about what's going on in the blogosphere, and we actually throw in a couple app suggestions along the way. I'm Lance.
I'm Sean.
I'm Trisson.
Okay, so at first, I wanted to say, have you guys ever had this?
No.
No.
It seems to be kind of popular these days. There's Cherryade, there's Limeade, and there's Lemonade. And they're made by Sunkist, which is an American company.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it's localized or not. I never saw this in the States. And that's one thing I love about Korea. Korea has some great drinks. And I think a lot of the drinks here would actually do really well in the States that you don't necessarily find.
Oh. You know?
I think Shike. I love Shike. Mm.
Oh.
And what's other one? Shujangwa?
Yeah.
Yeah, really. Cinnamony taste.
Cinnamony.
Yeah,
do you like think Americans will like that? Korean style drink?
The Shike one will be a little hard because it's got little pieces of rice in it.
Yeah.
I think that is kind of a mental block to get over. But as far as the taste, I have no doubt. Especially cinnamon. Americans love cinnamon. We put it in our gum. Right. We have cinnamon rolls. Americans, compared to Koreans, generally Koreans aren't big into cinnamon.
Right. I hated cinnamon when I was a kid, but I like it now.
You grow to appreciate fine tastes.
Right.
Okay, so let's get to our first story. What's your first story?
Oh, start with me?
Sure.
My first story is the movie I watched last week is Transformer 3. I was really looking forward to this movie before it released, and I finally watched it in IMAX 3D. Yeah! And it was really hard to get ticket for it, you know. There's only 3 theaters in Seoul that show the IMAX 3D. So, you know, I didn't know when it started to sell the tickets, so I was waiting. No, I was working, but at the same time, I tried to visit the site, you know, many times and try to see if there's a ticket open. So I finally got the tickets.
There's got to be an app for that that notifies you when something starts selling or when, you know, there's apps for, or at least internet sites will tell you when there's a discount, when a price drop or something. There's not for ticket sales?
But I asked the biggest Korean biggest movie theater chain in Korea, CGV. So I asked them when it opens, but they don't even know that. So I don't think they have that system that tells you when it opens. But once they have it, it'll be really good to have that app or some services.
So the movie.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I love the visual, but not the story, not the storyline, not that plot.
Let's not be a spoiler here. I haven't seen it, and I'm afraid they haven't seen it, but no details.
Yeah, if you want to watch this, if you didn't watch it yet, please don't expect for the story. Just expect for the visual, and please watch it in IMAX 3D. I watched it twice, actually, once with my guy friend, once with my girlfriend, and my guy friend liked it, but my girlfriend hated it.
She doesn't get into the visuals, she didn't, and the story wasn't there for her?
I don't think so, because I think this movie is kind of guy movies, so there's a transforming robots and hot girl. You know that, Gore was really...
You better hope your girlfriend's not watching this show.
Yeah. I won't tell her, but it's okay. It's just... she looks good. Okay. She's not that attractive, but she looks good.
We say she's easy on the eyes.
Yeah.
Very easy on the eyes. So when you saw it with your girlfriend, when that hot chick came out, did your girlfriend try to distract you, or was she looking at you to see how much you're looking at her?
Not actually, but if I was not with my girlfriend, I would say, wow, but I couldn't do it.
Yeah, you're like, gosh, nothing special.
Right, and that I'm really amazed by that visual effects and the spectacular, the scenes transforming robots. And yeah, if you like robots, yeah, it'll be good for you.
What geek doesn't like robots?
Right.
I haven't seen it yet. I don't go to the theaters a lot. I know you always tell me, Sean, oh, you gotta see it.
Yeah. And recently I realized that just near here, near your house, there's a really good IMAX theater.
Oh, really?
In the World Cup Stadium. You know where it is, right?
Yeah, I know there's a theater there, but it's IMAX?
Yeah, there's IMAX. It's one of the three IMAX theaters in Seoul.
Really? I didn't know that. Okay, then I'll have to try to go and see it. Okay. I'll go ahead.
And I'll go there tonight to see the Harry Potter.
Oh, really? To the IMAX?
Yeah.
You're all about IMAX.
Yeah, because it's a 3D movie, and my girlfriend also loved that movie, so we want to watch it. And I heard about that Harry Potter movie. It's the last one.
Mm.
But there's very good reviews out there.
Really?
Yeah. So I'm pretty looking forward to it.
Have you seen the first half of it?
Yeah, I saw it.
Recently?
Yeah. The last one, you mean?
Yeah, the last one, the first half.
Yeah. When it released.
When you released it. You should probably, I would suggest you watch it right before you go and watch the second half, so it's all fresh in your memory again. It's kind of my plan to do it. I'm not a big Harry Potter person, but I'm into movies, so I watch everything, even though it may be crap. Mm. I watched Source Code.
Oh.
Yeah, I thought... I don't know, it's missing something. There's just like this little thing that could have made it a great movie.
Right.
But to me, it's worth watching. You know, it's a watchable movie.
I like that too. I like that concept, but there's some, you know, like you said, there's something is not theoretically right, you know.
Mm.
But yeah, it's a good movie. And my friend's saying that it'll be easier for the movie makers because it repeats the scenes again and again, right?
It's cheaper for them, right? Your friend is a cinematographer or into movies or something? Why would he bring that up?
No, the female friends, they don't know much about movies, but they just think that it'll be easier.
Okay, my story. Can you pull up my tabs? The first one I'm going to do is, come on, tab boy. The first one, okay, I'll start with this one. It's on TechCrunch. I saw this on TechCrunch. And Japan just took over the steepest roller coaster in the world. And before it was France. And it looks like a blast. I love roller coasters. I love roller coasters. And it's one of the disappointments, honestly, about living in Korea. I don't think the roller coasters here are really special. It seems like they're made more for young children or people that aren't really into scary, scary roller coasters.
Did you try the one in the Everland?
Which one?
They made a big one recently. They made it by Oud.
Oh, no, I haven't been to that one. But those, to me, aren't very scary. Those are more nostalgic, you know, like remembering the past, the old wooden style. And honestly, I used to live in Southern California and we had Magic Mountain, and they have the Viper and the Batman and some amazing roller coasters. And
I've been there too.
Yeah, compared to that, it's, I don't know. And they have two there, or at least last time I went, two there that were that wooden style. And they weren't really scary, and actually, it's the old style, so you just, you know, you get shaken all around and it just beats the crap out of you. You get out of it and you're like, oh, my hip's sore, my foot's sore.
Yeah. And have you tried that? We are talking about the Korean, the amusement park. Have you tried the Lotte World thing, that Atlantis? No.
The one that's outside.
Yeah. It goes in and goes out. Yeah, it goes fly over the water, lake.
Four people sit across?
I guess so.
Because I got in line, right?
Yeah.
And I was actually with my daughter.
Oh.
I was with my daughter. And my daughter, this is a few years ago, my daughter was kind of at that height, and they have someone standing there with a stick that measures your height, and she was right at that line. So we're all nervous about, is she going to get rejected, and she really wants to write it, but maybe she's too short. And so we got up to the front of the line, and they brought out the stick and ignored my daughter and came to me and measured me. And they said, you're too tall. I'm like, what? I'm too tall? So I actually told them, I'll take off my shoes. I don't care. And they said, no, you can't do that. So I couldn't write it.
Actually, you didn't worry about yourself, right? You worried about daughters. But
right. It came down to me. So I wrote everything there except that one.
Mm. That was kind of the best low-coaster in Korea to me.
To you? You know, the revolution, which is inside one.
Yeah, French Revolution.
Yeah, it's a little bit short, but it's fun as a roller coaster. But again, kind of tame. And then what's the one underground? Meteor. It's underground. Meteor or asteroid?
Oh, that planet. We call it Hoksang Talchul in Korean. Escaping from a planet or something.
And the chairs spin.
Yeah, right.
So that makes, as you're going through this roller coaster, you're actually spinning. That makes it really fun. It's not scary, which I'm looking for scary, like something like this, but it's really fun. It's really fun. So, I don't know. I would love to take a trip to Japan. It's not very far, and possibly go on this roller coaster.
This is new one, right? Brand new one.
Yeah, brand new. Hey, let's watch a little bit of of what it's like.
It's a video. I didn't see it yet, too.
Okay, so they must be just coming out of the opening tunnel. Come on, get started already. Here we go. Wow. I always imagine some guy or girl.
Wow. Must be hard to hold his camera.
And it's probably a helmet cam. Oh. And it's a... Look, see this part? That's the part that's cool. And I don't fully understand this. Like, in the middle, it slows you down completely. And then takes you back up to go down that steep part.
They make it to prepare.
I'd never thought about that. Yeah, some anticipation to get more length of time out of the roller coaster so you feel like you're getting more of your money's worth. They said here on TechCrunch, they said it's $12.50. Mm. So it's not really cheap. For one ride, it's almost mano chanan.
Wow, it's like 90 degrees.
So I got a question for you guys. Would you rather ride in the front or the back?
I'll choose the middle. I figured out the middle is the best place.
What, really?
Yeah, because if it's front, it doesn't go... doesn't fall right away.
Right.
Ooh.
Here we go. Here we go.
Whoa.
Yeah, just wait.
Wow, you can't see the rail.
No, you're going to go under.
Wow.
Oh, I want to do it so bad. I want to do it bad. So you prefer riding in the middle. How about you, Jusong?
I don't want to ride any type of roller coaster. Actually, I have never tried to take the roller coaster.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You don't like some scary stuff?
I don't like it.
Oh, we should go somewhere.
Yeah, we should tie him up and put him on. Hey, even you know, Sedona, when she's 9 years old, she was riding roller coasters. What's that one, that gyro drop?
Yeah.
It takes you way up, and then all of a sudden, boom!
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a good one.
Really. You know, yesterday I asked to your daughter, what's your favorite doing stuff, kind of that, so she said she loved the ride a roller coaster, and she asked to me the same question, so I said, I like the work. but until 6 p.m., not over time.
After 6 p.m. For me, I prefer the back. Mm. The front is fun because you get to see everything, but like you said, it's slow.
Yeah.
You always hang, waiting for the back to catch up. So the back whips you around, you get a lot of speed, you feel everything.
Right.
So I prefer the back. Mm. Yep. I'd rather wait longer for the back than right in the middle or anywhere else.
Maybe in the... We had our first year anniversary, right?
Yeah.
If Yeah, if it, in our second anniversary, if we have, if we, our company grow up well, then we can go to Japan together. And
yeah, that would be good. That would be good. Chu-san?
Yeah?
You got a promise. You got a promise.
Okay.
You'll write one?
Oh.
Come on. Okay, we won't put that in. Okay, what's your next story?
My next story is about... okay. Go to next. Oh, it's about Final Cut Pro 10. I told you guys about this last week, and I actually used this myself. And I realized they call it, it's actually Final Cut Pro 10, but some people call it Final Cut Pro X. X stands for the brand new one, some totally new thing.
But also X comes from Roman numerals. Which means 10.
Right.
So a combination.
So, anyway, I used it and I liked it because I'm not a professional video editor. So, they actually made it really similar to the iMovie, the recent iMovie. So, if you have the Final Cut Pro, you don't even need iMovie. It's really similar and it's really easy to use. So, yeah, I could use this to edit my one-year anniversary video and my other videos too. And yeah,
but I guess to me I'm trying to move towards using the iPad to do my video editing.
So iMovie for iPad.
Yeah, iMovie for iPad. What am I missing out on?
You're missing a lot of things, I think.
Really?
It's really easy to edit, but there's some limited stuff iMovie for iPad, I think. Like, you can adjust the audio volume, like, lots of transition effects. That's kind of things.
So, getting transition effects, and it's worth $300?
actually, if you're not a professional, you don't need this. You can do this with your iMovie for Mac. Yeah, iMovie for Mac is a little bit more better than the iMovie for iPad, I think. So, yeah, just my short feeling.
But he's rich, so he can, even though he's not professional, he can afford it. Yeah, let's not talk about
okay.
that.
Okay. Okay, let's go to your story.
Okay. Next one of mine. I got, this week, a new one of the crazy iPad covers. You know, I'm sure you guys know all about it, you know. I did also the Peekaboo app, tried that out. That was kind of cool. That's kind of what this story's about. This Core Geek, it's on Core Geek, and he made his own smart cover. And I just think it's brilliant. I'm into crafty making stuff. That's kind of, I love that stuff, making stuff and figuring out how to make it. Not only did he make this out of duct tape, but he also put magnets in it that function the same as the smart cover.
Oh. Cool.
So I just thought it was really cool, clever idea. And he goes through, shows all the instructions, and it looks pretty good. You'd imagine, oh, duct tape, it's going to look terrible, but it looks really good.
So it means if you close the cover, it turns off automatically like that?
And turns back on, right, when you open it. Yeah, it's really slick. We've got a video for it, shows how to do it. So, you know, and it's much, much cheaper than right. this. I was just reading actually today in my RSS feed that this is a huge moneymaker for Apple. You know, it costs them, very little to make these. And the way Apple markets stuff, it's like, oh, you got to have one. Oh, yeah. They're just wonderful. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. But actually, I'm not all that impressed with it.
Apple convinced me totally with this.
No, you've been bugging me for weeks to get it.
Yeah.
The reason I broke down and I actually got it, because the other covers, they're roughly the same price. I mean, I could have gotten a cheaper one for maybe $35, and this is $50, so I could have saved $15. But the reason I got this is because it's lightweight and thin. All the other ones I found, you got to put some cover on the back, or... I just don't like that with my devices. I don't like covers on my devices. So this protects the screen without creating some bulky cover. So that's why I broke down and got it.
But the protection is weaker than the other covers because it just covers the screen, right? It doesn't cover the whole iPad. So if you drop it, it might be broken.
Maybe.
So try. So
right before we started recording the show, Jusung dropped my iPad. So it's still working. So hopefully it'll keep working. And you know, one thing that I guess bugs me a little bit, they had to make a decision. I assumed that the magnets would work on either side, but it doesn't, right? You only can use it on one side, which means I like to have the home button on the right, but then I have this pad hanging down. So it, you know, it doesn't give me the freedom. I'm not really impressed with it, but I guess it serves its function. It covers the screen, so.
Yeah.
$50 down the drain. Okay, that's my story. Now I'm sticking to it.
Okay, my next story is about Photovine. It's a new photo sharing service from Google. Google actually purchased a company called Slide last year, and this is made by Slide staff members, I think. That's what I heard. And these days, there are lots of, it's kind of trend right now, like making some app you can share photos or some posts with specific group, right? And I think this is not released yet, so they only have some website. But I think this is also, you can make a group and share photos with the group. So, recently, Facebook announced that they will release some photo group photo sharing app or service too. And yeah, this is from Google. And there was some app called Color before. They got lots of investments, but they kind of, it's not doing good right now.
But did you see, along these lines, I kind of got into Instagram. And for a while, I was doing Instagram all the time. And then, I don't know, the newness wears off and you try to build a community. And to me, honestly, Instagram turned into too many professionals. It wasn't a community based. It was like, oh, look at, I'm a professional artist kind of thing. Just personally, maybe I was following the wrong people or whatever. But now there was Mobley came out. It's Mobley.
Yeah.
And so that one's starting and it's getting a lot of press. But the one that I see now, and I didn't download it, and it's not part of my app suggestions because I haven't downloaded it yet, it's called Instacolor. Mm. And it's a cross between Instagram and Color, apparently. Mm. And so instead of where Color, you've got to define, okay, these group of people in this event, they're trying to go after it as in this location. So if you are in Hongdae, other people using the same app, you can kind of share photos with in the same area. But I don't know all the details yet, that I'm kind of guessing.
It's kind of mash up, right, to services. I really want this kind of service that you can share some photos just with your friends. Like, for example, if I go to a party, I just want to see all the pictures that all the people took in that party, right? But there's no service like that right now. There's no exactly perfect service for that. So everyone is trying then. So I hope this will, they will do good.
You know the problem with Color? I thought Color is a brilliant idea to me. But the problem with Color is you couldn't download the photos.
Right.
So as soon as, it was the problem to, in the beginning of Instagram, if I remember correctly, I would actually, if I took a picture within Instagram, I lost the picture, basically. I called it lost. Now they have the API and everything. But in the beginning. So Color needs to make the ability, some directory where you can go from that party, I want all the pictures that were taken. And then you can save them. But until they do that, it's just lost photos to me.
Yeah. I don't think it's difficult to make that, but yeah, they didn't support it.
I don't know if they had legal issues or, I don't know.
And I want to talk one more.
Can I ask, this isn't out yet. right? You have to request an invite.
Yeah.
Have you requested an invite?
Well, not yet.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I will.
I need to request one too.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, I'd really love to check this out also.
Yeah. And along the line, this is one of the app suggestions I brought up today. It's called Katango, and it's also like a group sharing app. So you can make specific group and you can share posts or photos for only for that group. But really brilliant thing they did is if you connect your Facebook account, they automatically analyze your relationship to your friends, so they make some automatic groups. So I tried it, so it's really precise and really it's really close to my real life. I mean, they group my some company friends, some church friends, and some Twitter friends. Yeah, and I don't know the details, the technology inside, but it's really brilliant.
And you can download it now? So it's available on, is it free?
Yeah, it's free. I downloaded it and tried it.
But you have to tie it into your Facebook.
Yeah.
I'm not going to use it.
Right. Yeah, probably. Maybe they will release some Google Plus version later, then you can use it.
Yeah, if it's tied into Google Plus. I don't use Facebook.
Mm.
But interesting.
Yeah.
Really interesting. You know, speaking about Google Plus, you know, I had to go out today, and then I came back and checked my Google Plus, mm-hmm. and there's no status update. Everything's blank now.
Did you put people in your circles?
Yeah, I have lots of people in different circles. I know people are following me, but instantly it said, you have nothing in your feed, you need to follow more people, or something like that. It's just weird. So I know, I've been reading in the RSS, related to Scoble, actually, mm-hmm. about Google Plus, when it first came out, it started to get a lot of spam. So I'm wondering mm-hmm. if they changed some system and all of a sudden my feed's dead. Because I had a feed before. You shouldn't have deleted it.
Oh. You mean on your Mac?
Yeah.
You went there with your browser, right?
Right.
I don't know. I've never experienced that.
It's really weird.
Always I have lots of feeds, so I can't read them all.
Someone needs to develop some app for that, either PC side or Mac side or actual app that filters it all and gives you the ones that you normally read. I don't know.
Like the Facebook does only filters some famous posts. Top news.
Facebook doesn't do anything good.
Google Plus is really doing good these days.
So what they say, 10 million users?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, they're really, you know, following the Facebook. Mm.
Yeah. All of a sudden I saw too, relative to their stock value, because they said because of Google Plus, all of a sudden, boom, it shot up.
They did a good job this time. Google Buzz was a kind of failure, but...
Well, you know what they did. It's basically a copy of Facebook.
Google Buzz?
No, Google Plus.
Plus, yeah. Right.
I mean, it looks all... Right. Just copy Facebook, you'll do okay.
Copy Facebook and put some additional stuff.
Yeah, like big circles instead of, other way to select. Gimmicky, but it's...
And I checked out their Android app. It's called... There's a Google Plus app, and they have Huddle. Huddle.
I heard about that. Huddle. Yeah.
Okay. Huddle app. That's one of that messaging app. Free messaging app. So you can send message to your circle, friends in your circle, and other friends. So if they release that iPhone version, I think I'll use that much. It's really good.
What I was reading today is Huddle. It's low publicity. They're not putting out any publicity.
Mm.
Yet, even with Google Plus, it's gaining. It's actually picking up a lot of users.
Right.
So, come on, bring it to the iPhone.
I heard they submitted, but Apple didn't approve it yet. Apple.
Well, you remember ours, when we first submitted, we got rejected.
Right.
So, that was kind of nerve-wracking. Why did they reject us? Oh, no! And it turned out, because Blogsy has the browser in it, unfiltered browser, you have to rate it 17 plus.
And we didn't know that.
No, so we rated it G rating or something. They rejected for that reason. But it was nerve wracking. We're like, oh no, what did we get rejected right. for?
Rejected? Oh.
I know. I feel so bad. Okay, into app suggestions?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Let's start off. The first one I've got, let's just go in the order that was in the tabs. Okay, this one, Teleprompt Plus. If you guys don't know about this, amazing app. Just, it truly is, as App Advice said, hands down the best teleprompter app for the iPad. And so basically, if you're into video production, you know you need a teleprompter, and you can set the rate to go through and process. And what I really like about it is it's got you can use the built-in camera function of the iPad. Mm-hmm. So if you want to create a podcast or something, you can write up your notes, have it slowly feed across, and use the camera and just speak into the camera as you read through it. I just think it's really amazing. It's really good app, and it's integrated. You know, it's integrated with Google Docs. You can go out and get docs that you've created, and it's just well around. There's too many features to talk about in it. It's just really well made. And now they have also, I don't know what the device is called, but some attaching device that you can use with your foot to either stop the teleprompter or speed it up and like that. So it's really good. Yeah, it's a tad expensive. It's $15, $14.99. But they're going after a niche market. Obviously, not everybody needs this product. Only people that are into video production. But if you're into video production, it's worth
it.
It's very good.
You couldn't try it.
I have it.
Oh, you have it? Wow.
Yeah, I have it. So it's really cool. Mm. It comes with what? The Gettysburg Address and Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. It just that's the two that it comes with natively to kind of walk you through and practice. And so I read both of those speeches and did it just to play with it. It was really fun. I felt a little bit like Martin Luther King or Abraham Lincoln.
I have a dream.
That all men. It was good.
Oh, good. It's my turn?
Yep.
This was one of the app suggestions of mine. And next one is... it's called... The Fantastic Flying Books of Mr. Maurice Lessmore. So,
flying books.
Books.
Yeah, not flying boobs.
Flying books. It's an iPad app, and it's an interactive ebook. But the guy who made it, I presume his name is Maurice Lessmore, and he was an animator in Pixar. And he got out from Pixar, and he made this animation interactive ebooks, and the quality is really good. It just looked like a Pixar animation. So, but it additionally adds some interaction stuff. So, if you see that trailer of this app, it would be really amazing.
So, how does the interaction work? Does it follow a pretty specific storyline? Are you able to interact and cause him to follow different paths along a storyline?
I just watched the short trailer, but it seems like, yeah, you have storylines, and if you drag something on the screen, the objects in the screen moves, but it's 3D, so it's really fantastic, yeah, as its name.
How much is it?
It's a $4.99, yeah. I didn't buy it. I'm thinking.
You're thinking about it? That's the problem. We don't want to buy all these apps that we're suggesting. I mean, they look great, but personally, I just don't have the time to play with all of them. And some of them, I just don't have the time to play with all of them.
So I think your daughters also will like it.
He's always trying to get me to buy apps. Okay. I gotta check that out. Okay, my next one.
Yep.
I'm not a big gamer, right? I don't typically game, but this thing got me addicted. It's Kona's Crate, and you actually have to use, you just touch either left or right, and you have jet packs, and you gotta get this crate over to Kona. And so there's this balancing adjustment and everything. Go ahead, take a look. It's super addictive.
Oh, have you played it?
Yeah, I downloaded the free version. You can get a free version that'll take you through actually quite a few levels. Some of them insanely difficult, frustratingly difficult, but that's only a couple of them. All the rest, they're difficult, but doable, very easily doable. And it's, yeah, really fun and addictive. You lost it?
Yeah, we downloaded it first, but yeah.
And I don't understand fully the storyline here. You know, Angry Birds has a good storyline. It's the pigs stole the eggs, yeah, and the birds have to attack them. And so they build this great story. This one has good graphics, good gameplay, good mechanics. It's got everything, but the storyline doesn't make any sense to me.
Oh.
You know, why do you have to get a crate to achieve?
Seems...
So you just gotta get that crate to him.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, and you gotta balance it and go through things. And of course, it uses some of the same dynamics that you see. I don't know if Angry Birds started it, but you have a bunch of different levels laid out, and then you can get up one, two, or three stars. And then also, a bonus on top of it is vines. So if you get through the whole thing without... Oh, wow, he caught it. If you get through the whole thing without touching any of the walls, then you get vines wrapped around your three stars, or one star, or whatever. So that's another kind of bonus objective you're trying to get. It's really addictive.
Is this an iPad game? Or?
Yeah, it's iPad. It's iPad, and it's the first, I don't know, 36 levels are free. Mm. So it gets you really addicted, and I'm probably going to break down and buy it. I'm not a big gamer, but when I find a game, I can't put it down. Mm. I did that with Plants vs. Zombies.
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't put it down until I finished the whole thing.
We both were very into that before.
Oh, we were competing about all the achievements.
Yeah.
So, okay, you guys should try that one.
Mm. Looks fun. Okay, is that all?
Yeah, well, now, the end of the show, it's Blogsy time.
Yeah.
And so, I guess the big news is...
We updated our Blogsy?
That's right. It's a gigantic news, and we're calling it The Monster. Do we have... Can you pull up the blog post?
Yeah.
Yeah, The Monster is just cram-packed. We tried to... Like we talked about in the podcast last week, we were really trying to focus on current users and make it a more positive experience for them, kind of polish Blogsy a little bit, give this little thing and that little thing. So some of the big ones... page support. Blogsy now does pages. You can create and manage pages. I think a lot of people ask for locking image proportions. So within the image menu, you can lock the proportions now and then type in either the width or the height, and the other dimension will expand or shrink proportionally. So lock proportions. I love this. Home button now in the browser, and also bookmarks. And they're easily managed through the settings menu. Offline support. But I want to clarify this. You know, I hope people don't think, oh yeah, I can do everything offline. Still, if you want to add images from Flickr or Picasa or YouTube videos, you have to have internet connection. So don't expect offline support to mean, oh, I can do everything offline. No, you still need internet connection. And that goes for tags and categories too, and some of those settings, you have to have the internet connection. So offline support means that now you're just able to access the directory of your locally saved drafts and save them, edit them, and then when you get in line, you can do the other settings and post it. So what are some other ones? What stood out to you, Sean?
We finally changed the right side UI. We changed the color. We added a dark theme, so you can now you can more recognize between two sides.
Mm. Yeah, that's a big one. And I actually like it. Yeah. I really, it's like a charcoal-y dark color.
Right.
And to me, as a bonus, it saves on battery life because you don't have to light the whole screen. It's charcoal now with white lettering. So I really like it and really distinguishes the two sides. So there's no confusion. Oh, the rich side, the right side. Right. So, I don't know. There's just so much to get into. You know, we really tried to satisfy a lot of the requests out there, things that people were asking for. Also, another one. I know some people asked, if you saw in our demo videos, if it's WordPress, in the API, you can fetch the tags. And so we're able to list the tags and make it easily selectable. In the Blogger API, they don't have that same ability. So the amazing developers here, the amazing programmers, they've figured out a way around that. So it's going to go out and fetch all those labels in Blogger in a different way and save them in Blogsy. So I think it's really amazing, that functionality,
right,
because it's not part of the API.
Right.
You guys have to understand that.
Yeah, we did it pretty good.
And then, of course, down here, I mean, it's filled. You guys are going to have your favorite feature, hopefully, that we added. But we didn't just focus on features. We focused on the back end, too. And if you saw our blog post earlier, we wanted to rebuild the setup portion so we could cover SSL. And I went into this last podcast. If you have password protected, making sure it sets up MU or MS WordPress setups correctly, you know, a whole bunch of things. Plus, analyzing the crash reports that a lot of you guys sent us. Thank you very much for doing that. And getting to the bottom of a lot of those bugs. And just on and on, you know, the bug report or the bug fixes too, I think, are pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Focused on.
I think it will satisfy many users.
Yeah, I sure hope so. If people hate this update, we might have to put our heads in the sand. And
we have our 1 year anniversary video following to this.
That's right. That's right. We have worked together now for 1 year. Actually, it's a little bit over 1 year, but schedules are busy and everything, so we couldn't celebrate it on the actual 1 year. So we celebrated it last Friday.
Yeah.
We had a blast.
Yeah, we had fun.
Yeah, we headed to Itaewon. You guys will see the video. Mm. We headed to Itaewon and we ate some good food, went, played pool.
Mm-hmm.
And before we went and played pool in the restaurant bar, we also played some darts. Just had a good time hanging out. So.
And we had amazing hamburger.
Yeah.
It's not easy to have that kind of hamburger in Seoul. Yeah, but.
No. And in the video, you'll get a little taste of it. Itaewon is kind of a foreigner's place, so tailors to foreigners and foreigner food and stuff like that outside of Itaewon. Mm-hmm. It's hard to find that Western style of food.
Right.
So we had a blast.
Yeah. You'll watch it.
I think that's it, right?
Yep.
Okay. See you guys later. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Hi guys, how you doing? We're going out for our 1 year party.
How do you feel?
Feel as normal.
Yeah.
And we're headed to Itaewon.
So, yeah, Itaewon.
We'll tell you more about Itaewon when we actually get there.
Right.
Welcome to Korean buses. Why are we taking a public bus? That's what you do when you're in Korea. They have excellent buses, go everywhere. They have an excellent subway system that keeps expanding every year. It's amazing. Okay, their drivers, both their bus drivers and taxi drivers, can be a little crazy. I can almost go from one end of Seoul all the way to the other end for around a dollar. We're in Itaewon. Itaewon, you have the American military base right over here. So if you think back about during the Korean War, this place became a place where American military would hang out.
And so it's become kind of the foreigner area in Seoul. It's a completely different atmosphere. You feel like it's almost part of a foreign country. You come here and there's lots of foreigners here. You go to the bars and to the restaurant and you see lots of foreigners, a lot of people speaking English.